So, as you all of you know, what are the objective of our course? To understand the mechanism of action, available doses, and how to use as per the psychiatric diagnosis. To understand both other side effect contraindications and various important drug interactions of these medications. How to identify and manage side effect a patient has due to prescribed medication. In this didactic, the medications are Neltrexone and Acamprosate. So there is no conflict of interest. It is only for the academic purpose. Zoom poll 1. So this is the question we are uploading on Zoom. Question is, Mr. A, 40-year male having alcohol use disorder. ODT is more than 24, so is highly dependent. With features of tolerance, craving, withdrawal, and significant social dysfunction. So in short, this is the case of alcohol use disorder. So the correct answer is, tablet Neltrexone, start with 25 milligram once daily for 3 days and then increase to 50 milligram once a day. After a week, it can be increased to 100 milligram per day. So there are so many anti-cravings, FDA approved and off-label. Normally, we have to consider the patient profile, liver profile, and renal profile, affordability, availability of the drug also. But if the everything is normal, there is no issue with general medical condition, then the most preferred drug is for the recent randomized controlled trials in alcohol use disorder is the tablet Neltrexone, because it works on the reward pathway, which is the major pathway for dependence and craving. So FDA approved agent, anti-craving agent are Neltrexone and Acamprosate. And the aversive agent is disulfiram, which we are going to cover in next session. So let's start with Neltrexone, where it will work. Early onset alcohol dependence syndrome, excessive craving, family history of addiction, wants to be a social drinker, binge drinking may be useful on the days when drinking is anticipated. So either Acamprosate, either Neltrexone or any anti-craving, it does not target the total abstinence. When patient wants a total abstinence, no alcohol at all, patient is highly motivated, then disulfiram is a good option. When patient is not ready, not so much motivated to complete all the alcohol, because our target is not to quit alcohol at all. If patient is ready to reduce amount, then it is okay. We have to move step by step, right? So if we want to decrease the binge drinking, if we want to decrease the number of the days the patient drinking, then Neltrexone is the good choice. How Neltrexone work? Neltrexone is an opioid antagonist. There is a reward pathway, mesolimbic pathway, which is responsible for the dependence and craving. There are opioid, endogenous opioid called endorphins and cephaline, which has effect on the reward pathway. And opioid is an opioid antagonist. Naltrexone blocks the effect of these endogenous opioids, like morphine, heroin, which are the exogenous opioids, people taking from outside. The similar chemical compounds are present in our brain also. It is called enkephaline and endorphins. So naltrexone is blocking the effect of these compounds. Oral Neltrexone tablet morning administration is recommended for improved compliance. Dose is 50 to 100 milligram. Injectable Neltrexone, a single kit, only one time use Neltrexone microspheres. You have to dilute prior to the administration, intramuscular injection, luteal region, and once a month. Normally in India, it is very less practiced. Implant Neltrexone are also there, not available in India. Side effect, so elevation of liver transaminase, LFT, you have to repeat every 3 months. Gastrointestinal side effect, nausea, vomiting, diarrhea, abdominal pain, non-specific low mood, dysphoria, anxiety. Reduction in motivational drive, patient may become amotivated. So you have to be cautious while prescribing in the depression. When patient come with the alcohol use disorder, sometimes there is two independent disorder. Alcohol use disorder patient also has a comorbid depression. So in this case, you should be cautious while prescribing Neltrexone, because Neltrexone can also produce the side effect which look like the depression. and you think that antidepressants are not responding, patient is not improving, but maybe this is the side effect of naltrexone. Precaution in people with chronic pain syndrome. Sometimes patient with somatic symptoms or some chronic pain syndrome, normal physicians and some the MD medicine and other healthcare providers are giving them the tramadol or other opioid preparations to reduce the pain. So in this condition, if patient is taking alcohol and you prescribe naltrexone, it will precipitate the severe withdrawal, severe opioid withdrawal. So if the patient is taking any opioid agonist, you have to be cautious. Very rare side effects of naltrexone are abdominal or stomach pain, blurred vision or swollen eyes, chest pain, confusion, discomfort while urinating or frequent urination, fever, hallucination, itching, mental depression or other mood or mental changes, ringing or buzzing in ears, shortness of breath, swelling of the face, feet or lower legs and weight gain. So some individuals, if some individuals have some hypersensitivity to naltrexone, then it can produce the swelling of the face, feet or lower legs. So the case presented by Dr. Desh Deepak, when the naltrexone has been given, patient presents with the swelling of the bilateral swelling of leg and facial edema. So the naltrexone, it's a very rare side effect of naltrexone. It can be because of naltrexone. In this case, you can think two things. One, it may be because of the side effect of naltrexone. The second thing, maybe there is some organic pathology, some liver pathology, some cardiac pathology, or some renal pathology. In these three pathologies impairment, there should be the chances of edema, leg edema or the facial edema. But as Dr. Desh Deepak told, that liver is normal, renal is normal, and there is no cardiac impairment. So in this case, we can think about the hypersensitivity to naltrexone, and the swelling is because of naltrexone itself. So adverse reaction to naltrexone and their management. If there is a nausea, suggest that the patient take naltrexone with a complex carbohydrate, like unko naaste ke saath roti ya bread ke saath lena hai, rather than on empty stomach. Suggest that the patient take naltrexone with a tablespoon of simethicone or bismuth subsalicylate. Reduce dose or stop hold for the 3 to 4 days, and then reinitiate at the lower doses. If there's liver toxicity, avoid naltrexone, discontinue naltrexone. Precipitated opioid withdrawal, discontinue further doses of naltrexone. As I mentioned, in chronic pain syndrome. Similarly, for any other reason patient is taking opioid, we have to be avoid naltrexone, because naltrexone is opioid antagonist. It will precipitate the severe opioid withdrawal. The muscle ache, rhinorrhea, salivation, diarrhea, and all the things, all the features you can find in opioid withdrawal. Naltrexone overdose, treat symptomatically under care, under close supervision. You have to monitor and manage ABC, airway, breathing and circulation. There is a drug interaction. If cough and cold medications, antidiarrheal medications and opioid analgesics, as I have discussed, these all the medications have some opioid components, some opioid agonists. So we have to be cautious while opioid antagonist. Thioridazine may result in lethargy and somnolence. Yoimbine, which is alpha adrenergic agonist, may result in anxiety and increased pulse and blood pressure. So we have to be cautious while prescribing this drug. And NSAIDs. NSAIDs may cause the difference in liver enzyme or some liver enzyme elevation, which is not good for the naltrexone. So we have to be cautious. Special population, renal impairment, not generally. In mild impairment, there is no necessity to decrease the dose of naltrexone. You can give safely. In moderate to severe impairment, there is no so much the studies available that what we have to do in moderate and severe renal impairment. In hepatic impairment, as we have discussed, you have to avoid naltrexone. Cardiac impairment, limited available data and that are not conclusive that what we should do in cardiac impairment. Elderly, you can prescribe it safely, but start with a low dose. Children and adolescent, no data available on safety and efficacy. Pregnancy, risk category C. Normally, when patient, pregnant woman, we should recommend that she should stop taking alcohol. This is the best option. Otherwise, there's a chance of fetal alcohol syndrome. Naltrexone is not generally recommended, but you can start at a low dose. There is not pregnancy mein aapko, you have to be cautious. Breastfeeding, some drug is found in mother's breast milk, but there is no any evidence suggestive of any malformation or any withdrawal features in neonate. So you have to be cautious. Now, Acamprosate. Where it will work? So late onset alcohol dependence syndrome, protected withdrawal. Who would like to tell about protected withdrawal? What is protracted withdrawal? So when the detoxification of the patient is over, you have started anti-craving and all, you have gradually taper of the benzodiazepine also, the lowest minimum dose of the benzodiazepine are there. Normally, the duration of the alcohol withdrawal symptoms are 7 to 10 days. In 7 to 10 days, they're gradually manageable, right? The very severe features like tremor or hallucinations, delirium or seizures, they can be occur up to 7 days. So after detoxification, in some patients, there is persistence of mild symptoms like some sleep disturbances, mild tremor, some anxiety and restlessness are there. So in it can be last up to 1 month to 6 months. So it is called protracted withdrawal. In this case, you have to assure the patient that because of the long duration of alcohol use, it can be present up to 6 months, and it gradually resolve when body get adjusted to, when the body function will gradually recover. So you have to give the reassurance to the patient. If patient is distressed, then you can prescribe a low dose anxiolytic in this case. So mild withdrawal features persist for 1 to 6 months in some of the patient. That is called protracted withdrawal. The main withdrawal has over, but some features left. So patient who aim for complete abstinence. So Acamprosate has also anxiolytic property. It is also act on the NMDA receptor. That's why it is helpful in protected withdrawal. Safer in patient with hepatic impairment, safer in patient with multiple medical issues, can be started along with the benzodiazepine detoxification. So it works on the glutamate receptor, NMDA receptors. So what we have learned is, because of chronic alcohol use, there is GABA level is GABA is acting on the CNS, and to balance, glutamate is increasing to balance the achieve the homeostasis. When patient suddenly stop in the withdrawal, there is a removal of the GABA inhibition and the sudden surge of glutamate activity, which is responsible for the withdrawal features of alcohol. So what Acamprosate is done? It acts on the NMDA receptor and manages the homeostasis between GABA and glutamate. So how to prescribe? In more than 60 kg, you have to give the dose of 333 milligram. The divided doses, 2 tablet morning, 2 tablet afternoon, 2 tablet evening per day. If adult is less than 60 kg, then you have to give tablet 2-1-1. Total doses 1332 milligram. Should begin treatment as soon as possible after achieving the abstinence, even during detoxifications. Continue for 1 year, 6 months to 1 year, we should continue. Taper not necessary at time of stoppage of medication. So if patient want to stop the medication, there is no need to gradual taper. There is no any evidence of withdrawal with Acamprosate. Zoom poll 2. What are the common side effects of Acamprosate? The options are diarrhea, abdominal pain, nausea and vomiting, pruritus, anxiety, severe depression, skin rust. Multiple correct answers are there. The common side effect of Acamprosate. The common side effects are diarrhea, abdominal pain, nausea and vomiting, pruritus, anxiety and skin rust. Severe depression is a real side effect of Acamprosate. Severe depression and suicidal ideas. So these are the side effects. So this patient presented by Dr. Desh Deepakji, he is presented with a skin rust, and it is very common side effect of Acamprosate because of some hypersensitivity issue. It depends on the individual. So when there is a side effect, you have to wait. You can adjust the dose, lower the dose, If side effect persists, discontinue the drug and add another anti-craving molecule. Drug interaction, it does not inhibit hepatic enzymes. So in liver pathology, acamprosate is safe, but it should be avoided in renal impairment. Do not use if patient has severe renal impairment if there is a proven allergy of acamprosate. So we also have to rule out if patient has any drug allergy or any kind of allergy with any drug or any food molecule. Warning or precautions, monitor patients for emergence of depressed mood or suicidal ideation and behavior or any non-psychiatric illness. Specific population in renal population, you have to be cautious. Start with the low dose. In moderate to severe impairment, it is not recommended. In hepatic impairment, dose adjustment is not necessary. Liver pathology, you can prescribe safely acamprosate. Cardiac impairment, limited data is available and it is not conclusive. In elderly, safely you can prescribe but start with a low dose. Children and adolescent, safety and efficacy data is not available, no randomized trial available at present for this population. Pregnancy, again, pregnancy category C. You should recommend to discontinue drug, discontinue alcohol, but if necessary, you can prescribe a low dose of acamprosate. Breastfeeding, the data are not available, so the exit, what is the final conclusion, inference for breastfeeding is not known. Duration and how to stop, it should be prescribed for up to 6 months or longer for those who perceive benefit and wish to continue taking it. Treatment should be stopped in those who continue to drink for 4 to 6 weeks after starting the drug. So patient admitted or not admitted, you have started the drug acamprosate or naltrexone. If patient continue to drink alcohol for 4 to 6 weeks and he is also taking this anti cravings, then you should stop the drug. Try to motivate the patient, admit the patient, achieve abstinence, and then. So these are the references. Thank you so much. So.